Do you know the medical term for someone who experiences herpes, cold sores, chronic UTIs, yeast infections, and BV? It's called being human. At HelloWisp.com, you can get the sexual health care you need same day without stepping foot in a doctor's office. Privately message a doctor online and get same day prescriptions for BV, yeast, UTI, STIs, herpes, cold sores, birth control, and emergency contraception delivered discreetly to your home for free in all 50 states. Or sent to your local pharmacy to pick up within 3 hours. Take 10% off your first order with the code HEALTHY only at HelloWisp.com. That's Hello, WISP.com.
It's Thursday, June 17th. I'm Oscar Ramirez from the Daily Dive podcast in Los Angeles, and this is Reopening America. The housing market continues to have a much lower supply of homes needed to meet the demand, and now we have a better idea of how many are needed. A new report by the National Association of Realtors says we need 5.5 million more housing units, everything from single-family homes to multifamily units. The report does call for policy responses, some of which are in President Biden's infrastructure proposal. Nicole Friedman, housing reporter at the Wall Street Journal, joins us for more. Thanks for joining us, Nicole.
Thank you for having me.
We love bringing you on to talk about the housing market and how crazy it has been. You know, one of the ongoing themes that we've seen lately is that the demand for houses is far more than the supply that we have. And we just got a report from the National Association of Realtors, which is giving a number to how many more housing units we need. They say that we need 5.5 million more units. Nicole, tell us a little bit about what we're seeing in this report.
So the National Association of Realtors just came out with this report that kind of attempts to quantify the deficit. And so what they did is they basically said from 1968 to 2000, the kind of annual building rate in the U.S. was about 1.5 million units a year. And then in the past 20 years, from 2001 to 2020, the annual rate fell to less than 1.3 million new units a year. And so they're saying basically in the last 20 years, the U.S. has not kept up with kind of the long-term historical level of housing construction. And so they're saying if the U.S. had stayed at that long-term historical level of 1.5 million new units a year, then there would be 5.5 million more units in the market today.
And in the report, they say that we basically need everything. Help us break down that 5.5 million because we need single-family homes, buildings with 2 to 4 units, and beyond that as well.
So this is trying to cover the entire housing market. So that 5.5 million includes for sale housing, but also includes rental housing. It breaks down the 5.5 million. They say the need is about 2 million single family homes. And then the rest is in multifamily. It's 1.1 million buildings with 2 to 4 units, 1 million units in 2 to 4 unit buildings, and then 2.4 million units in buildings with 5 or more units. So those might be your big apartment buildings.
We've seen home prices rise 19% this past year and everything. So, you know, the prices are going crazy. We know that the price of lumber is pretty high right now. Shortages of appliances are also factoring into a lot of this stuff. What did the organization, the National Association of Realtors, what did they call for as far as how to fix this? Because we'd have to build extra homes every year, I think they said, over the course of a decade just to make up for this.
So that's what they're saying, is that to kind of fill this deficit, that builders would have to kind of really ramp up the pace of construction above what they're doing today for the next decade or so. And builders have definitely increased their activity, especially in the past year, as there's been a lot more demand. But there are some obstacles in terms of material costs and how quickly they can acquire new land or hire more workers. And so builders do face some limits in how quickly they can grow. And so the National Association of Realtors is saying there should be a federal policy response, and that, you know, maybe in the infrastructure package, that housing should be included as critical infrastructure.
Yeah, some of the ideas that they were proposing are present in President Biden's plan. I think they also said that it would create 2.8 million jobs if they were to increase construction of these units that we need. The number does differ, though. So this is a report from the National Association of Realtors. They say 5.5 million, but there are some other studies and housing economists that say that that number is a little different, maybe less that they were pointing to.
So there's definitely disagreements among people who study the market. You know, how big is this deficit? Everybody agrees that right now demand is above supply, but by how much is, you know, something that different experts have different takes. And so one consultant I talked to says they think that the shortage is actually less than 1 million units, and so much smaller than what the National Association of Realtors thinks. And they're factoring in population growth and saying that the population is not growing as quickly as it used to. And so maybe we don't need to be building at those same long-term historical levels that we were building back in the second half of the 20th century. So there's definitely some debate among, you know, how big the shortage actually is and what kind of response is needed.
Yeah, that was an interesting quote right there. That was from John Burns. He's an industry consultant. He said our adult population isn't as growing as fast as it used to, so they don't need to build as much. And I'm curious if he's pointing to, you know, we hear a lot of stories about millennials and staying at home longer. I mean, that just points to the need for more affordable housing, it seems like, because the stories that we hear are always that people are living at home longer because they can't afford to buy homes or continue to rent, things like that.
So it's definitely hard to say. These are all kind of assumptions that analysts need to make. You know, how much of young people living at home longer is because of affordability and they, you know, want to start their own households, but they are unable to do so, versus how much is it, you know, that people are getting married later because they want to get married later and that's a cultural shift that is distinct from the affordability concerns. And so everybody kind of has their own assumptions about how quickly household formation is going to be growing, which is, you know, a really key kind of input to any of these types of assumptions.
Well, we'll keep following along this crazy housing market with you, Nicole. Thank you. Nicole Friedman, housing reporter at the Wall Street Journal. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
I'm Oscar Ramirez, and this has been Reopening America. Don't forget that for today's big news stories, you can check me out on the Daily Dive podcast every Monday through Friday. So follow us on iHeartRadio or wherever you get your podcast.
Look, staying healthy isn't easy. Watching your diet, hitting the gym, avoiding stress. But a good night's rest helps boost your overall health and wellness. And it couldn't be easier. The new Sleep Number 360 smart bed is the only bed that effortlessly adjusts in response to both of you. The result? You wake up ready for anything. Proven quality sleep is life-changing sleep. During our summer sale, save up to $500 on select Sleep Number 360 smart beds, plus special financing, only for a limited time. Special financing subject to credit approval. Minimum monthly payments required. See store for details.